Thank you, Governor. Good afternoon. I also want to wish a blessed and happy Passover and a happy Easter to those who are celebrating this weekend. As the governor said, we have 334 new cases today. This brings our total to 2,349. That means we are continuing to advance our approach that the governor has shared over the last couple of weeks of being very deliberate and strategic, expanding our testing. We will then see increased number of cases and be able to activate our expansive contact tracing program. So continue to log your contacts so that we can start to activate, making sure that people are reached who need to for quarantining and for isolation if they actually have symptoms. As the governor also shared, we very sadly have 7 additional fatalities to report. We now have 56 COVID-19 associated fatalities total. One of the people who passed away was in their 50s, one person was in their 60s, and the other 5 were in their 80s. Given that older adults and people in congregate settings are more vulnerable to the complications of COVID-19, we continue to work very closely with nursing homes, group homes, other congregate settings, as we have been discussing. In advance of the holiday weekend, we had a call yesterday evening with nursing home leadership to once again reiterate the absolute directive to not allow any visitors to their facilities. These facilities are also taking the very aggressive approaches that we have in place, screening every single healthcare worker, checking for temperatures multiple times a day, sending anyone home who has any symptoms, and surgical masks for those who are healthcare workers working in nursing homes as well as in hospitals. We understand that the message to families to not visit those in a nursing home is a hard one. We know that that has been difficult over this time. People want to be with their loved ones all the time, and especially on the holidays. On top of that, it's our traditions, our family traditions, our faith traditions, that are very powerful in grounding us and bringing solace during difficult times such as this. We understand that people want to connect this weekend and on every other day. Our ask is that you please be a little creative. We want you to know why we are saying there are absolutely no visitors, no packages being sent. It's to keep people safe. In knowing that, and everyone being on the same page in agreement that that's what we ultimately want to do, we want to keep Rhode Islanders safe, we want to keep our nursing home residents safe, we want to keep our healthcare workers safe, then we have to be creative on how to continue to show the love that we know continues for those in nursing homes. It's critical that we cannot gather in groups larger than 5 with anyone, anywhere. And we cannot visit people in nursing homes. Ways to be creative includes just picking up the phone and calling, includes doing a video chat. We absolutely want you connecting with your family members in nursing homes, and we definitely want you to let them know how much you love them. But we need you to find other ways to do it so that everyone can be kept safe. You cannot do it in person. That also means cannot go to the windows of nursing homes. We've heard about people going to nursing home windows, and with the weather getting nicer, sometimes those windows are getting opened to speak to the nursing home residents. That's almost as equivalent as face-to-face contact. It is not safe. It is not allowable. We must not do that. We must find ways to communicate with our loved ones remotely. being creative. Please do not go to the windows of your loved ones at nursing homes. That was a key message on the telephone call that we had with nursing home leadership yesterday, that they shared of wanting to get this message out to families. We also talked to nursing home leadership yesterday about packages and deliveries. Every time a new person comes into a nursing home, such as a delivery person delivering a package that you've sent, that is a potential new exposure for those residents as well as for the staff. It is not safe. Given the situation that we have in nursing homes, we want to take every measure we can to limit risks of new infections. We are doing everything we can to limit the traffic at nursing homes. I shared yesterday how even for going into a nursing home resident's room, we are looking to, and spoke yesterday again with nursing home leadership, about having one person do the task that three and four people used to do, just so that we can limit the different types of people entering nursing home resident rooms. We want to do the same with limiting different types of people entering nursing home resident facilities, and that includes delivery people. So we want to tell you in advance now, please do not send packages and flowers to your loved ones in nursing homes for the holidays. Shouldn't be done anytime, but it's a particularly important message during this holiday weekend. Again, our word today is being creative. You can be creative. Take a picture of the flowers you bought and send it to mom or dad or grandma or grandpa on a phone via text, or whoever the person is that you know in a nursing home, be able to send the picture to them via text or some other electronic way. You could also do a video chat to show them what you bought. But please do not physically send it. We know this is a stern message. It's uncomfortable for me. We want usually people to really be experiencing and receiving the love, but this has to be a stern message. Everyone understands what's happening in nursing homes and what's potential in other healthcare facilities. And as I said, we all agree that we want to keep all Rhode Islanders safe. In order to do that, we need to be as aggressive as we can to stop transmission and introduction of any new cases. We ask that you please understand that intent and to continue to work with us in helping you to keep your loved ones alive. I want to add another message. We've been contacted by a lot of people saying their employers are requesting doctor's notes to allow them to come back to work after being in isolation. We understand the desire for that, but we also want to find a way, working with employers, to make it so that we are not overwhelming our healthcare system with the request for notes in order for someone to work. We will continue to work with employers and their employees on this, but I want to make this statement. You can return to work without a doctor's note if you have had COVID-19 or a COVID-19 illness, as long as it has been at least 7 full days since symptoms of COVID-19 or a COVID-19-like illness started. And as long as you have had no fever for the last 3 days of that illness, and that's without taking any medication to reduce fever. You have to be fever-free for a full 72 hours during the last 7 days of that. And all of your symptoms have to have resolved. So that can sometimes take longer than the 7 days. It has to be a minimum of 7 days. 3 days with no fever and no medication to reduce fever and all symptoms resolved. That is the message that we're giving employers of when it is then safe to return to work. All people who go into isolation because they are sick with symptoms of illness should stay in isolation completely until they meet all of those criteria, period. However, if you are someone who is still working, a doctor's note should not be required to go back to work after your period of isolation ends. We will continue to support employers with the information needed to help address that and want to make sure that we are doing it in a way that does not overwhelm the healthcare system with needing notes. So we'll continue to equip you with that information. Again, I want to wish everyone a blessed weekend and holiday. If you follow the governor's recommendation about getting fresh air because it is nice outside, remember to wear your cloth face covers so that you are preventing spread of any illness or infectious particles, even if you are feeling fine. Remember to wear that outside. Remember your 6 feet of social distancing. And remember, it should really be as few people as possible. We're saying less than five, really two, three, and it should only be the same people you are with. That's an important message. It can't continue to be today you go out with these three people and then tomorrow it's with a different three people. Choose those same folks that you are with, that you live with from your household, that you are looking to stay safe with.